السلام عليكم.
وعليكم السلام.
بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. صحيح البخاري حديث 1891 and 2 1893. كتاب الصوم باب وجوب صوم رمضان. كتاب الصوم under that first باب is باب وجوب صوم رمضان. It starts with بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. كتاب الصوم باب وجوب صوم رمضان. وقول الله تعالى يا أيها الذين آمنوا كتب عليكم الصيام كما كتب على الذين من قبلكم لعلكم تتقون. Chapter regarding the wujubiyat of Ramadan. Ramadan first. Babu wujubi sawmi Ramadan. Wujub means that which is compulsory. That which is
compulsory
or obligatory or mandatory. Okay, like that. So the wujubiyat, the compulsory nature of Ramadan fasting is described here. Three hadiths are there. Hadith number 1891 to 1893 of Sahih al-Bukhari. Firstly, there Bukhari mentions one verse of Holy Quran. This verse number 183 of Surah Al-Baqarah. أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. يا أيها الذين آمنوا كتب عليكم الصيام كما كتب على الذين من قبلكم لعلكم تتقون. Recite.
يا أيها الذين آمنوا كتب عليكم صيام كما كتب على الذين من قبلكم لعلكم تتقون.
كتب عليكم الصيام. Then. Oh you who believe. يا أيها الذين آمنوا. Oh you who have believed. Oh you مؤمنين. Oh you believers. كتب عليكم الصيام. Decreed upon you. Is that? It is. Fasting is decreed upon you. Or decreed upon you is fasting. Means fasting is made obligatory or compulsory for you, upon you. Okay. Then. كما كتب على الذين من قبلكم. As it was decreed upon those who before you. That is, before the Ummat Muhammad.
Also,
there was fasting for the different communities or for the different people, for the different ummat of different prophets. There was fasting. The nature, the type of fasting may be different. Still, there was fasting. كَمَا كُتِبَ عَلَى الَّذِينَ مِنْ قَبْلِكُمْ. مِنْ قَبْلِكُمْ means?
Before
you. Those who were before you. It is قَوْمُ عِسَى. قَوْمُ مُوسَى. Like that. يَعَلَّكُمْ تَتَّقُونَ. So that you may become pious. You may become people having taqwa, piety. Or you may become righteous people. Righteous. Then, first hadith. حدثنا قتيبة بن سعيد حدثنا إسماعيل بن جعفر عن أبي سهيل عن أبيه أن طلحبة بن عبد الله أن أعرابيا جاء إلى رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم صائر الرأس فقال يا رسول الله أخبرني ماذا فرض الله علي من الصلاة فقال الصلوات الخمس إلا أن تطوع شيئا فقال أخبرني ماذا فرض الله علي من الصيام فقال شهر رمضان إلا أن تطوع شيئا فقال أخبرني بما فرض الله علي من الزكاة فقال فأخبره رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم شرائع الإسلام قال والذي أكرمك لا أتطوع شيئا ولا أنقص مما فرض الله علي شيئا فقال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم أفلح إن صدق أو دخل الجنة إن صدق. Then, narrated by طلحة بن عبيد الله. طلحة بن عبيد الله narrates this hadith. أن أعرابيا جاء إلى رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم. One day, an Arabi, a Bedouin Arab, a village Arab, came to, that means,
came
near, came to Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam,
the
messenger of Allah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, sa'ir ar-ra's with unkempt hair. So his hair was not combed. He kept it, and his hair was unkempt, kept properly or not combed properly like that. Sa'ir ar-ra's. قال. Then he asked the Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, Ya Rasulullah, O Messenger of Allah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, أخبرني ما رفض الله علي من الصلاة. You inform me what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has made compulsory for me or upon me from prayers, from salah. So what thing is made compulsory or obligatory for me or upon me from salah, from prayers? You inform me. فقال. Then Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam replied, الصلوات الخمس, the five times prayer. That is, five times prayer is compulsory upon you, or obligatory, or mandatory upon you. إلا أن تطوع شيئا, except that you perform optional ones. That is, except that you perform optional ones. So only five times prayer is
compulsory.
Yes, compulsory. All others are optional. So except that which you perform optional or nawafil like that. Then, فقال. Then he asked, أخبرني ماذا فرض الله علي من الصيام. You inform me. This village Arab Bedouin asked Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam again. Second question. أخبرني ماذا فرض الله علي من الصيام. You inform me about what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has made compulsory or obligatory upon me from siyam, from fasting, water fasting. So then Rasul sallallahu alaihi wasallam replied, فقال شهر رمضان إلا أن تطوع شيئا. The Ramadan fasting, except that which you perform or observe as nafil fasting. So only شهر رمضان, the month of Ramadan, is compulsory for fasting in the month of Ramadan. Only that one is compulsory. That one is wujub. All others are nafil, optional. Okay. فقال. Then he said, أخبرني بما فرض الله علي من الزكاة. Then he said, you inform me about what is made compulsory by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala from zakah upon me. Then فقال. Then the narrator continues. فأخبره رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم. Then رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم informed him. أخبر means
informed.
Who?
Allah.
Him. أخبر who? أخبر رسول. He informed who? Him. Who? The one who came there. The Bedouin. The village Arab. The Arabi. Okay. شرائع الإسلام. The hukums. The rules of Islam. So, just like that. Sawm, Zakat, Hajj, like that. Now, Shara'i'ul Islam. Or the fundamental rules of Islam. He informed, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, informed this Bedouin Arab, or village Arabi. Then he said, that is, this Bedouin or Arabi said, وَالَّذِي أَكْرَمَكَ لَا أَتَطَوَّعُ شَيْئًا ولا انقص مما فرض الله علي شيئا. Then he said, by him who والذي اكرمك, by him who has honored you, who has honored Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, who has honored Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Akrama means honored, aadarichu, aaran nabi aadarichathu, who has honored. Yes,
Allah
subhanahu wa ta'ala. So by him who has honored you, walladhi akramaka means by him who has honored you, means by Allah, wallahi means, okay, walladhi akramaka means by him who has honored you, that means by Allah, I say. That is, what is that? وَالَّذِي أَكْرَمَكَ لَا أَتَطَوَّعُ شَيْئًا وَلَا أَنْقُصُ مِمَّا فَضَّلَ اللَّهُ عَلَيَّ شَيْئًا. He said, by whom he has, who has honored you, I said, that is, I will neither perform any nawafil or optional one, nor will I decrease. Nakasa means to decrease. I will decrease, nor will I decrease that Allah has enjoined as compulsory on me. That is as mandatory on me. So I will neither do more nor less. I will do only that which is made compulsory for me. Okay. No optional one I will do. Only compulsory ones. Wujub. Wajibat. Only wajibat I will perform. That is that which is those acts, those amal, which are compulsory, which are obligatory. Only that much I will do. Then I will not reduce in it. Okay. I will not decrease in it. And that I will not add any nawafil. That means I will not perform any nafil, any optional ones. Okay. Follow?
Yes.
Then what was the reply of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam? Qala Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Then Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam replied, aflaha in sadaq. He will pass. Just to pass. Aflaha means to pass. He will succeed. He will be successful. Aflaha in sadaqa. In sadaqa means
truth.
To say the truth. Said the truth. Sadaqa. Sidaq means truth. Sidaq, truth. The master form. So if he is saying the truth, if he said the truth, in sadaqa, if he said the truth, aflaha, he will succeed. He will pass. He will get the pass mark. So if an examination, if the maximum mark is 100 and the minimum marks required for a pass is 40, 40, then if one person gets 40, he will pass. If one gets 99 marks, he will also pass. Okay. But if the person gets 39, then he will fail. He will fail. Okay. Then, so here also it is like that. If one perform only farz, wajibat, then he will pass, just pass. Okay, minimum pass. Okay. Aflaha in sadaqa. Or the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said what? Aw dakhala al-jannata in sadaqa. Or he will enter paradise, enter jannah in sadaqa if he said the truth. If he said the truth, it is okay, he will enter Jannah after his death. Okay. But so from this hadith we can understand that if one person perform only fara'il or only wajibat, only what is compulsory for him, then if that thing is that amal, his amal, his acts are perfect in that respect, then he will enter Jannah. It is true. But sometimes some defects will be there. Then he will not get the minimum mark required for a pass, required for the ticket to Jannah. So he will not enter admission, okay, into Jannah. So we have to perform nawafil also. Then it will be compensated. If anything is there, if any defect is there in our wajibat, in our compulsory items, compulsory a'mal, then it will be compensated by the additional ones, that is the nawafil. Okay. Sometimes there is more chance for in our ibadat to have some defects. Okay, some minuses will be there. Okay, so we have to perform. Actually, we have to perform nawafil too. Okay. So here, the wujubiyat of Ramadan. Here, Ramadan fasting is mentioned. That means Ramadan fasting is compulsory. Also, from the verse that Ya ayyuhalladhina amanu kutiba alaykumus siyamu kama kutiba alalladhina min qablikum. From that verse also, it is understood that Ramadan fasting is made compulsory for all Muslims. Okay. Next hadith. Hadith number 1892. عن ابن عمر رضي الله عنهما قال صام النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم عاشوراء وأمر بصيامه فلما فرض رمضان ترك وكان عبد الله لا يصومه إلا أن يوافق صومه. Narrated ابن عمر رضي الله عنه قال صام النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم
صلى الله عليه
وسلم Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم performed or observed fasting Ashura. Ashura. Ashura means
tenth.
Say loud.
Tenth.
Ashura means not Ashura. Ashura means
ten.
Only ten. Ashura is called Ashura means the tenth of Muharram is called Ashura. It is tenth of Muharram is called Ashura. Ninth of Muharram is called Tasu'a. This A means
nine.
So Tasu'a, ninth of Muharram. Ashura, tenth of Muharram. So Rasul sallallahu alaihi wasallam observed the fasting of Ashura means he observed fasting, optional fasting during the 10th of Muharram. 10th of Muharram. The first month of Hijra calendar is? Yes.
Muharram.
The first month of Hijra calendar is?
Muharram.
Then, wa amara bisuyami. Rasul sallallahu alaihi wasallam performed or observed fasting of the 10th of Muharram, the Ashura fasting, and wa amara bisuyami. And then he ordered, he commanded his followers to perform, to observe fasting of Ashura. Amara means?
Ordered
or commanded. Yeah, then, falamma furila Ramadan. Then, when Ramadan was made compulsory. So, firstly, there was Ashura fasting. And at that time, Ramadan fasting was not made compulsory. Okay? Laterally, it was made compulsory. So, falamma furila Ramadan. Then, when Ramadan fasting was made compulsory, turika, it was abandoned. That is, Ashura fasting was
abandoned,
given up. No fasting. Then, فَقَانَ Abdullah. Then, Abdullah, لَا يَسُومُهُ Abdullah used not to perform Ashura fasting, إِلَّا أَن يُوَافِقَ سُومَهُ Except if it coincided, or unless it coincided with the routine fasting by chance. That is, if Abdullah used to fast from first of the Muharram, or if he fast the 13th, 14th or 15th, that is Ayyamul Bidh fasting or any other fasting, and it is coincided with the 10th, it is previous day fasting, the same day also fasting, the following day sometimes fasting. So if it coincides like that, then only he used to perform the 10th of, observe the fasting of 10th of Muharram. So he never did perform Ashura fasting as Ashura. Okay. So Ashura fasting was abandoned when Ramadan fasting was made compulsory, made obligatory. Okay. Then next hadith. And Aisha radiallahu anha. أن قريشا كانت تصوم يوم عاشوراء في الجاهلية ثم أمر رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم بصيامه حتى فرض رمضان وقال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم من شاء فليصم ومن شاء فأفطر. That is narrated Aisha رضي الله عنها. The tribe of Quraysh used to fast on the day of Ashura in the pre-Islamic or Jahiliyyah period, and then Allah's apostle صلى الله عليه وسلم ordered, commanded Muslims to fast on it till the fasting in the month of Ramadan was prescribed. So when Ramadan fasting was made compulsory, Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam said what? Whereupon the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, he who wants to fast Ashura may fast, and he who does not want to fast may not fast. Only that was. So before Ramadan fasting, Ashura fasting was there, the 10th of Muharram. Then when Ramadan fasting was made compulsory, Rasul sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, man sha'a falyasum wa man sha'a faftar. That is, if one needs or if one wants to fast, he may fast, no problem. And if one wants to abandon fasting of Ashura, then no problem, he can abandon. That is, it is made optional. Okay, from this hadith we can understand that after Ramadan fasting it is made optional. Okay. نو الشرح from فتح الباري قوله بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم كتاب الصوم كذلك الأكثر وفي رواية النسفي كتاب الصيام وثبتت البسملة للجميع. والصوم والصيام في اللغة الإمساك، وفي الشرع إمساك مخصوص في زمن مخصوص عن شيء مخصوص بشرائط مخصوصة. وقال صاحب المحكم: الصوم تعريفه ترك الطعام والشراب والنكاح والكلام، يقال صام صوما وصياما، ورجل صائم وصوم. وقال راغب: الصوم في الأصل الإمساك عن الفعل، ولذاك قيل للفرس الممسك عن السير صائم، وفي الشرع إمساك المكلف بالنية عن تناول المطعم والمشرب والاستمناء والاستقاء من الفجر المغرب. ني شرح as given in فتح الباري by إمام ابن حجر الأسقلاني. yes sir, not allowed you are saying. then in most of the reports it is قوله بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. so this kitab, kitab الصوم under صحيح البخاري, إمام بخاري starts with بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. Means in the name of
Allah.
Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim. Full. In the name of Allah, the beneficent, the merciful. Yes, yes.
Merciful.
Yes. Kitab al-Sawm. Kitab al-Sawm. The book of fasting. Kadari al-Akthar. It is in most reports. It is Kitab al-Sawm. Wafi riwayat al-Nasafi. And the, in the report of Nasafi, it is Kitab al-Siyam. Sawm jam'a.
Siyam.
Som jamme?
Siyam.
Wa thabatat al basmala lil jami'. In all reports there is Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim. Starting with Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim. In the name of Allah, the beneficent, the merciful. Or you say like that, the beneficent, the merciful. Rahman and Rahim. Rahman. Mubalighat. Rahman. Rahmat. Okay. Rahim. Like that. Then. الصوم والصيام. صوم or صيام. صوم المفرد or singular form and صيام the plural form. Okay. في اللغة it is in language. Literally it means الإمساك. Holding, withholding or controlling. Controlling or withholding like that. وفي الشرع and in a legal term. It's legal term. Legally it means شرعي. It's meaning in شرع. That is إمساك مخصوص في الزمن مخصوص عن شيخ مخصوص بشرائط مخصوص. مخصوص means definite. Indefinite period. That is controlling or withholding something or some special things, some definite things, some definite items in a definite period. That is, and in a definite way, definite type of controlling in definite, in a definite period. That is regarding certain items or definite items with certain or definite conditions. That is called so. So in its legal definition. وقال صاحب المحكم. And the author of Muhkam says, الصوم, so تعريفه, its definition is ترك الطعام والشراب والنكاح والكلام. This abandoning, giving up طعام. طعام.
Eat.
Eat, yes.
Eat.
Eating. Ta'am means eating. Eat. Food. Tarking. Tark ta'am means giving up food. Washarab. And drinks. Wa nikah. And sexual intercourse between the couples. Or sexual intercourse. Wal kalam. And unwanted or silly talks. Okay. That's called so. Now. الراغب وقال الراغب راغب سي الصوم في الأصل الإمساك عن الفعل. الصوم صوم in its original sense it is withholding from some action or controlling some action or keeping away from some actions. Then ولذلك للفرس الممسك سي the official and its legal meaning or شرعي meaning is إمساك المكلف بالنية أن تناول الطعام طعام والمشرب والاستمناء والاستقاء من الفجر المغرب. This, he says, the process by which a mukallaf, mukallaf means one who is an adult, you are adults, okay? So, the process by which a mukallaf or a mukallafa or adult gives up food, drink, sexual enjoyment from fajr or dawn, from morning to maghrib, that is to dusk in the evening, Maghrib time. With the niya, with the intention that he is performing, he is observing fasting for the sake of Allah. That is called sawm. Okay, fasting. Now, قوله باب وجوب صوم رمضان. كذلك الأكثر. والنسف باب وجوب رمضان الفضل. Now, باب وجوب صوم رمضان. In most of the reports, the name of the bab is like that. And in the riwayat, the report of Nasafi, باب وجوب رمضان wa فضله. It is like that. That is, the regarding, the chapter regarding the wujubiyat, the compulsory nature of Ramadan, fasting and its merits. Fadl means merits. Merit. وَقَدْ ذَكَرَ أَبُو الْخَيْرِ الطَّالِقَانِ فِي كِتَابِ حَضَائِرُ الْقُدُسِ لِمَرَضْوَانِ 60 إِسْمَ 60 means?
60.
60, yes. So, أَبُو الْخَيْرِ الطَّالِقَانِ says in his kitab, in his book called حَضَائِرُ الْقُدُسِ that there are 60 names for Ramadan. Okay, 60 names. ذكر بعض الصوفية أن آدم عليه السلام لما أكل من الشجرة ثم تاب تأخر قبول توبته مما بقي في جسده من تلك الأكلة 30 يوما فلما صفى جسده منها طيب عليه ففرض على ذريته صيام 30 يوما وهذا يحتاج إلى ثبوت السرد فيه إلى من يقبل قوله في ذلك وهيهات وجدان ذلك. No, some Sufis say that or mentioned أن آدم عليه السلام certainly آدم عليه السلام لما أكل من الشجرة for آدم عليه السلام Allah said to آدم عليه السلام said لا تقربا
هذه الشجرة
yes.
هذه الشجرة
لا تقربا هذه الشجرة don't approach or don't eat from this شجرة in the heavens. Okay, then آدم upon the inspiration from Satan, he ate from that shajara, that tree. Okay, and when he ate it, thumma taba, then he repented to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Okay, ta'akhara qabulu tawbati, but Allah kept pending, accepting his tawbah, his repentance, kept pending. He didn't accept it at once, he kept it pending. مما بقي في جسده من تلك الأكلة. So some remnants were there in his body. That is the parts of that which was eaten by Adam from that shajara, from that tree, was there in his jasad, in his body for 30 days. Okay, 30 days. Then for that 30 days, for those 30 days, his tawbah was kept pending. Acceptance of tawbah was kept pending by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Then, فَلَمَّا صَفَى جَسَدُهُ مِنْهَا then after this 30 days, 30 days, when his jasad, his body was purified from what he ate, from the forbidden tree, then his tawbah, his repentance was accepted by Allah subhanahu تعالى. Then, that's why فَفُرِضَ عَلَى رُدُّيَّتِهِ سُيَامُ ثَلَاثِينَ يَوْمَ that's why 30 days of fasting was made compulsory upon his offsprings. It is on all people, men and women. Okay, so this report is not confirmed at all. Ibn Hajar radiyallahu anhu himself says وَهَذَا يَحْتَاجِ إِلَى ثُبُوتِ السَّنَدْ فِيهِ إِلَى مَنْ يَقْبَلُ قَوْلُهُ فِي ذَلِكَ وحيهات وجدان ذلك. So it is not confirmed. It is not a confirmed report. Okay. Some Sufis says like that. Only that much. Then. قوله وقول الله تعالى يا أيها الذين آمنوا كتب عليكم الصيام الآية أشار بذلك إلى ما بدأ فرض الصيام وكأنه لم يثبت عنده ولا شرطه فيه شيء فأورد ما يشير إلى المراد فإنه ذكر فيه ثلاثة أحاديث حديث طلحة الدال على أنه لا فرض إلا رمضان وحديث ابن عمر أو عائشة المتضمن الأمر بالصيام عاشوراء وكأن المصنف أشار إلى أن الأمر في روايتهما محمول على الندب بدليل حصر الفضل في رمضان وهو ظاهر الآية لأنه تعالى قال كتب عليكم الصيام ثم بينه فقال شهر رمضان. Then here in his صحيح البخاري إمام بخاري say mention first the verse of Allah. That is verse 183 of Surah Al-Baqarah. Ya ayyuhal ladhina amanu kutiba alaykum as-suyam. So it indicates that the wujubiyat of soul, the compulsory nature of Ramadan fasting is mentioned, is indicated here. Also, Bukhari didn't mention anything about the criteria of soul here. Then, also, here Bukhari mentions three hadiths, 1891, 1892, 1893. Three hadiths we have discussed. Okay, three hadiths. One hadith is Tulhah of Tulhah, radiallahu anha. That hadith mentions the compulsory nature of Ramadan fasting. That is the person, about the person asking questions. What is made compulsory from Sawm, from Siyam, from fasting upon him. Then Prophet said, Shahr Ramadan. So it is understood that Shahr Ramadan fasting is compulsory or obligatory. Okay, follow. That's next. Then the two hadiths that follows, that is hadith of Ibn Umar Yallahu Anhu and hadith of Aisha Yallahu Anha. Yes, Asanti. Very good. Then, so those two hadiths, two reports are about which soul, which fasting?
Ashura,
the 10th of Muharram. So here the author indicates that this fasting, regarding the fasting of Ashura, it is only optional and not compulsory. Okay. But Ramadan fasting is not like that. It is compulsory. Here Allah says, Kutiba alaykum as-siyam. Kutiba, it is decreed upon you. It is made obligatory upon you. Then it is explained in which month? That is Shahr Ramadan alladhi unzila fihi al-Qur'an. Kutibale. Hello. Ik di class edan nammade edan da da ada ada to re
an
shahr ramadan alladhi unzila fihi alquran. In another verse Allah says shahr ramadan, the month of Ramadan, alladhi unzila fihi alquran, in which Allah revealed alquran. So in that verse Allah mentions the wujubiyat, compulsory nature of Ramadan there also. So it is understood that Ramadan fasting is made compulsory. Okay. Now, وَقَدْ اخْتَلَفَ السَّلَفُ هَلْ فُرِضَ عَلَى النَّاسِ صِيَامًا قَبْلَ رَمَضَانَ أَوْ لَا فَالْجُمْهُورُ وَهُوَ الْمَشْهُورُ عِنْدَ الشَّافِعِيَّةِ أَنَّهُ لَمْ يَجِبْ قَطُّ صَوْمًا قَبْلَ صَوْمِ رَمَضَانَ وَفِي وَجْهٍ وَهُوَ قَوْلُ الْحَنَفِيَّةِ أَوَّلُ مَا فُرِضَ صِيَامُ عَاشُورَا فَلَمَّا نَزَلَ رَمَضَانُ نُسِخَ فَمِنْ أَدِلَّةِ الشَّافِعِيَّةِ حَدِيثُ مُعَاوِيَةَ مَرْفُوعٌ لَمْ يَكْتُبِ اللَّهُ عَلَيْكُمْ صِيَامَهُ وَسَيَأْتِي فِي أَوَاخِرِ الصِّيَامِ وَمِنْ أَدِلَّةِ الْحَنَفِيَّةِ ظَاهِرُ حَدِيثِ حَدِيثَيْ ابْنِ عُمَرَ وَعَائِشَةَ الْمَذْكُورَيْنِ فِي هَذَا الْبَابِ بِلَفْظِ الْأَمْرِ وَحَدِيثُ رُبَيْعَةَ بِنْتِ مُعَوِّذٍ الْعَتِيِّ وَهُوَ أَيْضًا عِنْدَ الْمُسْلِمِ مَنْ أَصْبَحَ صَائِمًا فَلْيُتِمَّ صَوْمَهُ قَالَتْ فَلَمْ نَزَلْ نَصُومُهُ وَنُصَوِّمُ صِبْيَانَنَا وَهُمْ صِغَارُ الْحَدِيثِ وَحَدِيثُ مَسْلَمَةَ مَرْفُوعٌ مَنْ أَكَلَ فَلْيَصُمْ بَقِيَّةَ يَوْمٍ ومن لم يكن أكل فليصم الحديث. وبنوا على هذا الخلاف هل يشترط في صحة صوم الواجب نية من الليل أو لا وسيأتي بحث فيه بعد 20 باب. Next, there are differences of opinion among the Salafs as to whether the fasting was made compulsory for the Ummah Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam before Ramadan fasting came into being. Whether there was fasting before Ramadan fasting was made a rule. There is difference of opinion among the Salafs, among the Salaf, that is, among the Imams, okay, of the past. And that is, فَالْجُمْهُورِ, and the prominent view, most of the scholars said that, وَهُوَ الْمَشْهُورُ عِنْدَ الشَّافِيَةِ, and in Shafi Maslak, it is the prominent, famous view also, mashhur view, that is, أَنَّهُ لَمْ يَجِبْ قَطُّ صَوْمْ قَبْلَ صَوْمْ رَبْضَانِ. So, before Ramadan fasting was made compulsory, there was no compulsory fasting at all. That is the view of Shafi'i, Shafi'iyya, Shafi Maslak. And yes, then Next, فَلَمَّا نَزَّلَ رَمَضْوَانَ نُسْخَ Then, Ramadan fasting was made compulsory. It was abrogated. That is the view of Hanafi. That is, Hanafi's view that before Ramadan fasting was made compulsory, Ashura fasting was compulsory. And Ramadan fasting was made compulsory, then Ashura fasting abandoned. Or its compulsory nature was abrogated. It is the view. Okay. And both the groups or scholars, both the schools, they quote their adillat or proofs. Here, Aisha radiallahu anha and Ibn Umar radiallahu anha, hadith, Hanafis quote. There, the amr, the sigha amr is used. So, it is command, they say. So, it was wajib then. When Ramadan fasting was made compulsory, its compulsory nature, that is the compulsory nature of Ashura fasting was abrogated. Only that much. Okay. Assalamu alaikum.
Wa alaikum salam.